print IPP service, but the scan IPP service and perhaps fix out altogether. And so scanners and faxes are treated like printers and appear in the printer setup tool. And so now we have the IPP service list manager GUI. This is the main screen of the GNOME Control Center printer module. And here it was got coded in the Google Summer of Code 2021 already. And it is naturally GTK plus based and ready for inserting in the GNOME Control Center. It discovers the services using Avahi, and it checks for duplicate entries and removes them so that all is nicely sorted and user-friendly, printer and scanner also together, and has buttons for the web, has buttons for the device's web interface. Then, in 2020, in the Google Summer of Code, another student has written the IPP system service GUI. So this student has written the dialog, which is opened when in the list of IPP services, you click the button for the IPP system service. It's also ready for being added to the GNOME Control Center. And now we need still a tool to guide the users setting up non-driverless printers. And this is planned to be done in Google Summer of Code 2022 this year. And naturally only under the condition that we get enough slots from Google, so that we can accept the student who has applied for this project idea. And so it replaces the former at printer window. We detect, discover all non-driverless printers on USB and in the network. We find printer applications. Check also which printer applications are locally installed. Perhaps we have already the right one. And finding out which printer applications are in the Snap Store, we use the service on open printing. This we have to do, it's a workaround, because I've done a feature request to the Snap Store for searching snaps by hardware signature, and no one has worked on that. And so this, and with this way, one can easily set up the printer, the printer application for the printer. And here we install the printer application, which open printing tells us which is the right one, and install the printer in the printer application. And then we will, after that, see the service, see the printer's IPP service in the main window, and we can print on it. And what we still need for the printer setup tool, once it's the third component, as I said, the add non-driverless printer. We have also to put all the three components together so that we get one new printers and scanners GNOME Control Center module. For this, if all works nice, we will get a second Google Summer of Code student this year. And we work for this, this second Google Summer of Code student will work closely together with our desktop team at Canonical and with the design team, so that we finish up a nice module to submit upstream. And in the middle of the project, I will be on the Guadec in Mexico, and there I will give a report in my talk there, which is otherwise similar to this one. I will give a report on the progress of that. twin dialogues also need to work with the new architecture. And the most important thing is, at first, they need to support temporary CUPS queues. These queues, which CUPS and CUPS clients automatically create based on discovered IPP printers, which are created only for the job, for doing the print job, and removed 1 minute after the print job is done. And many print dialogues still do not support them. Fortunately, the GTK dialog has it already fixed. But there are many print dialogues. There's the Qt dialog, there's the LibreOffice dialog, the Chrome, Firefox, and I don't know whether really all of them are fixed. So everyone who is responsible for a print dialog should check this and fix this. And another point is, on CUPS 3.x, there are no PPD files at all. If you have the current CUPS 2.x, even if it's in a snap, you can, with some API, download the PPD file from CUPS. This is not possible anymore in CUPS 3.x because it simply does not support PPD files anymore. So in this point, the print dialog has also to be checked that it does not try to download the PPD file of the print queue from CUPS, because this is not possible anymore. And even it should also not try surrounding CUPS by directly getting to HTTP localhost 631 printers qname.ppd. And so these 2 points have to be taken into account, and the print dialog will make it also working on under CUPS 3.x. But we can make it much better, because now we have to fix the CUPS, the print dialog, and all these print dialog in these 2 points. But later on, something will happen. Perhaps something else will be changed in the print architecture, and the print dialog stop working again and need to be fixed again. And also, it can happen that there's a new cloud printing service, and it would be nice if the print dialogs support this cloud printing service too. And therefore, we want to do it better. We do the so-called we separate the support of the print technologies like CUPS or print to file or like any cloud printing service into so-called print dialog backends. And the backend supports the print technology, is connected by dbus with the dialog with the front end, and so the dialog does not need any more take care of changes in CUPS and so the creators of the dialog, the GUI toolkit developers, do not need to keep pace with it, which is especially difficult because they have also rather long release cycles. There's low motivation to maintain the print dialog and so on, and so we separate this. And this we call the common print dialog backends. It was already developed in the Google Summer of Code 2017. And it follows a former development. Formerly, we tried to do something different. We tried to get a common dialog provided by the desktop, the print dialog provided by the desktop and not by the application, so that all applications have the same print dialog to make it easier for the user to see always the same print dialog. And this we called common print dialog. But we failed with it because did not have enough people to code on it. And later on, but one thing is interesting. We failed on it, on this idea, but this idea did not die. The Flatpak people had the same idea, but with another background, to let the system, the desktop environment, access the user's files through the dialogues, but not only print, but also open and save. And this way, allow the encapsulated application in the Flatpak access the user's files. I don't know whether the Flatpakers came to the idea by itself or whether somehow they found my idea of 10 years ago. It's all free software, so they were not obliged to ask me. So, and later on, we looked into perhaps reviving this idea, but in the end, we came up to the mentioned common print dialog backends, not common print dialog, meaning that we leave the dialog with the application, but the dialog does not support CUPS and print to file and cloud print services by itself, but shouts into the dbus and the backend support CUPS and print to file and the cloud print technologies. And so for CUPS, open printing can take the responsibility of the print dialog all working with CUPS. All print dialogs always working with CUPS. And so open printing would always update the dialog backend for CUPS and for print to file too. And if someone offers a cloud print service, they would also issue the common print dialog backend for it, maintain it, put it into the Snap Store. And if someone wants to use the service under Linux, he installs the Snap with the backend. In this way, all print dialogs show the printers in this cloud print service. And for this, we have already the dbus interface, we have backend and frontend libraries. The only thing which is missing is that the print dialog adopt the common print dialog backends system. And we have also Google Summer of Code students, a project idea, Google Summer of Code contributors, do not need to have to be students. And if we would get enough slots, we let a student work on this, a contributor work on this. So, this I have already told. Here's the scheme. This is an original drawing from the Google Summer of Code contributor who has started on this project in 2017. So we go directly to the application distribution. Another thing is we have distribution independent packaging. There is Snap, there's Flatpak, and there's UpImage and Docker and so on. And for printing, and one thing is we have snapped CUPS, we have snapped print applications. Snap seems to be the most sophisticated. One can snap package system daemons, but one cannot Flatpak system daemons, one cannot put system daemons in an UpImage. And so CUPS exists only in the Snap and not in other distribution independent packaging formats. Same for print application. And many people are complaining about Snaps. There's only one Snap Store's monopoly and so on. And they are slow in startup and so people are complaining. And I want that one can get CUPS also in another format. And I reviewed Flatpak and UpImage, and they seem to be only for applications. For example, Flatpak interacts with the desktop to access the user, to access the user files, and then one cannot really run them as root. And UpImage has no security concept. You cannot run this as root too, and so they are not suitable. But I talked with the Flatpak guys, and there's a trick that one can make a Docker container of cups, so that I will do in the near future an official Docker container of cups. There are many unofficial third-party ones from people who have uploaded them, and I will make one which is really coming from open printing and as universal as possible, and not containing drivers. Is the problem as driver support we do not need anymore, as we have print applications. And with this, there is a way that when we have a system which is Flatpak based, we can somehow get the Docker container in, or directly when we have a server where we want to simply use Docker, we can use the Docker container too. And so we will have a second way to provide cups as distribution in the package, same for the printer applications. But the printer applications, perhaps I can do another trick, running them for flat packing them, running them as the user, and letting them start when he logs in and letting them stop when he logs out. I have to look into this too. So this is distribution independent packaging of cups and cups and printer applications. And I also in Snap have integrated the cup snap completely into SnapD with an own interface named cups, so that if you snap an application, user application which prints, you can securely print. And it is not possible for the application snapper, the application packager, to let administrative requests like creating queues, deleting queues, deleting someone else's job, reading someone else's job by the application through this interface, and so it's secure. So this way, the developer, the Snap developer, can upload it in the Snap store, and as it's not dangerous, he does not need permission from the Snap store team. He can simply upload, and his application can print. And for Flatpak, we have something like the common print dialog, so it just prints. And for AppImage, we have no security shell around the application, so it just prints too. But AppImage, be careful. It can also administer cups and mess up your queues and AppImage. But Flatpak, as it goes through the print dialog, Flatpak itself is protecting against administrative requests to cups. And that's it.
All
any
right.
Questions?
Yeah, we got applause first. I think we have 30 seconds for one question. And if there's no question, then thank you, Till. That was a great talk. It's good to know printing just works. Yeah, you can ask Till a question and get a t-shirt. It's good for you. Okay, thank you again. Whee! All right, moving on to the next talk in this room.
Thank you.
You're the next speaker? Good. So the next speaker, we're just going to go plunk and HTML. Does it work? It works fantastic. Okay, so this mic is live if you want to speak here. That's good. Yeah, you look very serious like that.
Yeah.
Very good.
All right.
All right. So we started the day with Flutter stuff and about Flutter visuals. And so we're getting on in the day, and it's time to figure out how to get your Ubuntu visuals into Flutter. Take it away, Frederick.
Hi, everyone. So I'm Frederick, and I'm part of the Ubuntu Yaro community team, and we are a team of...
Okay. The printer talk was given by no other than Till Kamppeter. I probably am butchering his name. This is Tumbleweed, as you can maybe guess from some of the dialogues already. But I haven't updated this in a while. This is an i3 4 gigs Lenovo Yoga 11 inch, so it's a small machine. It doesn't run this slow usually, so I'm not sure if it's a mix of being a low powered machine and also running on a second monitor, and maybe there's something about when it comes to printer loading printer stuff, it just takes forever. Do not know, but now it is 24 minutes to add a printer. Okay, status is ready. Up. Just print and test page. Single test page. Oh, there it is, and it works. Don't know why it's defaulting to like none of these. You gotta click on it. You gotta click on local and remote to show. Well, it works. It printed. Took a little extra, but it worked. Yep. Just don't know why it's taking forever. The dialogues and the pop-ups and the S, but it works.